waking up to water everywhere.
We were watching the bomb because it rained all night.
The rain filling the streets, coming out drains, rushing down suburban creeks in the Gap and here at Pullenvale. Kedron Brook bursting its banks and swallowing the parkland around it.
Brisbane Automatic Weather Station recorded 183.6 millimetres, and that is the highest 24-hour total that we have seen since February 2022.
The overnight downpour leading to flash flooding across the southeast.
Very nervous because we live in a spot around the corner where we're almost up to our third flood.
It made the morning commute a challenge around Mount Cutha as roads turned into rivers. Emergency services called to this car in Kenmore Hills to check there wasn't a driver inside.
Notably, it was how much rain fell in shorter periods of time.
Bray Park spared after the floods 2 weeks ago.
It's a little bit worrying, but you can see the council's cleaned out all the catchment and they've made it so water can get out really quickly.
The highest totals, 209 millimetres at Rosalie, most falling in 6 hours. Mount Cutha received 195 millimetres in 24 hours, 148 after 1 a.m. 191 fell at Bowen Hills and 175 in Toowong. In Kedron, where they're used to flash flooding, even the locals were taken aback by just how quickly the water rose, catching drivers by surprise. This driver chose to push ahead in spite of the warnings, the car losing traction as it crossed the flooded road, the passenger filming the journey. Another had water over the bonnet and up the windscreen as those behind decided not to risk it.
Look, if you don't have to be on the road, don't be on the road.
On the Gold Coast, residents watched Oxenford Weir rage.
Very frightening. I believe there's power outages as well.
Just come down to have a look for fishing and stuff like that.
As the day progressed, the rain risk shifted to the Sunshine Coast. At Biwa, a man was found naked and clinging to a tree and told rescuers he got into trouble trying to cross a creek yesterday, washed away along with his clothes, now being treated for hypothermia and exhaustion.
We've had to go out to at least 7 swiftwater rescue events overnight. We've also had over 175 calls to state emergency services for assistance.
Local councils say they were caught by surprise. Moreton Bay and Gold Coast mayors criticising forecasts.
The forecast was to be around 20 mil, but early this morning we already cop 100 mil.
The Weather Bureau says models didn't predict how widespread and heavy the rain would be, explaining it's unusual for a weak upper trough to cause a coastal trough to form.
So it's a very unusual situation to see such widespread rainfall being caused by an upper trough. So we were starting to issue warnings from 1 a.m. this morning when it became evident that that was occurring.
Compounding the problem, it took another 6 hours for Brisbane City Council's alerts to be issued.
Didn't bother me too much. But everyone would have probably preferred a text.
The operator of the system, WeatherZone, experiencing a technical error.
We've asked WeatherZone for a please explain. It's simply not good enough.
7 News tried to get in touch with WeatherZone but had no response. Well, thankfully, the rain did ease off throughout the day. Many of those flooded roads have since receded. But a lot of that rain had to go somewhere, and we have received or have seen releases in dams across the southeast. Here along North Pine Dam, they started releases around 3 o'clock this afternoon, and they will continue through the weekend. Also releases from Somerset into Wivenhoe. They will continue until Monday.
Ned Balm there at Joiner. Well, now to Sam Payne, and Sam, the Gold Coast wasn't spared either.
Sharon, some northern suburbs were hit hard, receiving more than 100 millimetres of rain. The wet weather proved problematic for drivers. A car was caught in floodwater in Helensvale. Another spun out on the motorway, causing a major traffic jam. The beaches remained open, but the weather did deter swimmers.